The abbot gave me permission to access the computers here. Ah, yes, I heard about what you did. Thanks for taking care of that situation. Here's the access key. Hands you the key. Enjoy. Thanks. See you around. The computer near me should have some information about it. You now have access, so take a look for yourself. Vault 13. That's interesting looking. A security access card still in working condition. Must be pretty heavy, it's a whole pound. I'm saving again, just in case the game crashes again like it did. Did I get XP? Guess not. You insert the access card into the slot. Beep! Access card accepted. Loading wind blows. Loading wind blows 2075. Done. Input command. Play rock, paper, scissors. Okay. Scan files. Read the help about me. Excellent. Congratulations on successfully installing Windblows 2075. This version is the most advanced Windblows version to date. With the probability of only one crash per million function calls confirmed, our technicians are confident that Windblows is perfect for any corporate environment. The newest addition to Windblows 2075 is an improved and tweaked code base, which now only weighs 15% of your CPU cycles on background administration as opposed to previous versions, which would waste up to 25% of your CPU cycles. Oh, 10% more? Of course, much user consideration has been put into this latest release. As with previous versions of Windblows, the common commands of search, add, move, delete, and format are available to the user. Oh yeah, we have an option to format. Not going to do that yet. In fact, not for quite a while. Play Rock, Paper, Scissors. Rock, Paper, Scissors version 0.3. Select an option. Rock. Terminal makes selection. Calculating. Draw. Terminal wins. Paper. Okay. That was not much fun. Scan files for any information on GEC or Vault 13. You find some files containing the words GEC and Vault GEC. Your eyes widen and your heart quickens as you discover what appears to be an old advertisement for a Garden of Eden creation kit. The ad depicts a grinning cartoon guy in a vault suit holding up a large case that says, Survival Kit. It's almost as if the smiling bastard is taunting you. According to the ad, the kit includes a base replicator unit, which replicates food and basic items needed for building your new world, a holodisk reader with library, which includes selections from the Library of Congress, complete set of encyclopedias and other life-saving information, all contained on 460 handy holodisks. That's it. How's it fit in that little thing? That little attaché case or whatever. And it even contains a miniature pen flashlight. Surely this miracle device is exactly what you need to save your dying village. As you read over more articles, you learn the GEC was developed by Future Tech, a division of Vault Tech, and that it was the standard issue in all Vault Tech vaults. It was meant to be used upon exiting a vault to help reestablish life in the harsh environments of a world devastated by nuclear war. Upon further reading, you discover the GEC isn't quite the miracle device the ad made it out to be. The base replicator is actually nothing more than a fertilizer system containing food, seeds, soil supplements, and chemicals specifically engineered to turn arid wasteland into fertile soil. Its claim that it can build basic items actually alludes to new codes it provides for the vault's machines, allowing them to create new items from the dispensers. The GEC also contains schematics for basic force fields and the construction of sandcrete walls and buildings. It seems the Gek itself is meant to be disassembled over the course of its use. You read an example of how its cold fusion power source is intended to be used for main city power production. The Gek even contains instructions on disassembling sections of the vault to create homes and defensive structures for the new community. As you finish reading over the files, you decide that even though it's not the magical device the Elder seems to think it is, finding a Gek is still your best option if you hope to save your tribe. Browse files pertaining to Vault. You browse over the files, which contain mostly government propaganda for how amazing life in the vaults would be. You learn that in the mid-21st century, the U.S. government commissioned Vault Tech to construct 122 vaults across the United States. These vaults were meant to serve as shelters for up to 1,000 U.S. citizens in the event of a nuclear holocaust. Within the safe confines of the underground vaults, the vault dwellers could live out a luxurious existence as they await the signal informing them that the surface world is once again inhabitable. You continue browsing the files, but the only mention you find of Vault 13 simply states that it's located in California, which doesn't help you much. Add information? You have nothing to add back. Huh. So I wonder if any of these, now that we've seen this, let's save. I wonder if these other terminals have other information. So I can't get to that one. Yes, greetings to you, brother. Alright. Weren't there some terminals in another room? Maybe not. Why'd I hear that? I heard the ocean. Right, we can't get to that one. He's in the way. Can I push him? Oh. He just goes back. Certainly interesting. These old books are very fragile. An old woven floor rug. No, not yet. Not leaving yet. Not leaving this floor. That's what you mean. Alright. Still haven't found out who's digging up the grave, so I guess it wasn't the death claw. I found stuff about botany. Actually, it's over here, isn't it? I have to bring these guys with me. Unfortunately.
What do you want?
Let's go.
You want me back now?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Back to hell. Can't leave. Have to get the robot now. did I come in? And how do I get over there? Time to go back downstairs. Yeah. Yes, leave. So I have... I read that already. Guns and bullets. See if we can see what's down as well. Attach the rope. I did just pick up a rope, didn't I?
What you be need?
Oh god, no. That actually scared me. Does nothing. Yeah, I'm supposed to just wait here until midnight anyway.
What you be me?
Oh god, Sulik, stop. I am trying to attach something here. And that's not the way to do it. Tell me what you be needing one more time. It does nothing. Alright, what? 9:45, so we only wait like 12 hours? Grunting, grunting. Hello. Who are you? Oh. That's you. I never saw him run before. I'm just waiting for something. I thought that was thing was coming at me. I thought that was a grave robbing thing. Is that the rustling with look at him? Huh. Waiting for midnight. What is this? Come from the well or something? I'm kind of nervous about this. I'm not gonna be able to see it. I just wanna see if those go to other zones or they just all go outside. Says he heard it in his field. That was our friend here, Marcus. Serious, it takes so long. Ten minutes. Alright, screw it. Midnight. Okay, I'm starting to feel like an idiot out here. Hunched over. The old man jolts with surprise when he sees your approach. Look, I really must be going. Now you hold on a minute. You grab the man by the arm as he begins to walk away. Who are you, and what are you doing here at this hour? Never mind that everyone else is out anyway, including little kids. What? Why, the name's Tom, and can an old man enjoy your nightly stroll anymore without being asked a bunch of questions? Alright, fine, but why are you carrying a shovel? You mean this old thing? He glances down at the rusty shovel in his hands. Well, you never know when you might find something that needs digging up. Always be prepared, I say. Find something, huh? You mean something in a grave? Tom's eyes widen. I'm not quite sure what you, mean. Tom, you're in a graveyard. Actually, it's outside a graveyard. You've got mud all over you, and it's past midnight. Why, even Tor... Who's Tor? ...could draw a conclusion from this. It's time to start giving me some answers, Tom. Why are you digging up these graves? He puts down the shovel and sighs. Alright, I'll tell you. My body ain't what it used to be. I got no job and no real means to get food. I know grave digging ain't something that folks smile upon, but it's been a way for me to bring in some money. I'm just trying to survive. I don't mean no harm. I do want to bring this up. I heard you've also been stealing crops from the farmer here. The old man fidgets uncomfortably. I couldn't help it. I was just so hungry and the food looked so good. Please. I don't mean any trouble. Look, I'll just go away and you won't see me here again, I promise. Wait, no need for any of that. The Petersons own the farm here and they're extremely nice people. Mr. Peterson even offered to talk with whoever was taking his crops and come to a reasonable agreement. Go talk with him. I'm sure he can help you out somehow. The old man's eyes light up. That doesn't sound like a bad idea at all. Hey, thanks. Maybe this world ain't as cruel as I thought it was. You take care, then, Tom. I'll check with you later and see how things are going. 1,000 experience, 5 karma. You figure out who is digging up the graves and set Tom towards a new life. I sure hope that Peterson fella is as friendly as you say he is. Alright, let's wait till morning. I'm gonna go talk to these people. He's still walking around. Clears his throat. Talk to Peterson, Samuel. Hick! Hello again. I took care of the grave digging situation. You shouldn't have any more problems out here. Well, that's hick! Good news. Glad I won't be falling into any more hick graves. Thanks for the help. I don't think open graves are the real reason you're falling down, Samuel, but you take it easy now. Can't resist that. Alright, let's talk to the persons. He's walking out. See Tom, he's got a smile on his face and he's wearing new workers' clothing. I think it said. Hey there! Wow, you were right. That Mr. Peterson is one kindly fella. He forgave me for what I did and even offered me a job helping out in the field. He says once I pay off the food I've taken, I'll start making a weekly salary. Thanks again for your trouble. You're welcome, Tom. You take care of yourself now. Alright, wait a second. I want to give you something for helping an old fella like me out. I found this lighter on some land I dug up a couple weeks ago. I have no use for it, and hopefully you might. Okay, so just in case we didn't have a lighter, guys, I guess we give this lighter to the guy down in the basement. Making the alcohol. Thanks, Tom. I'm sure this will come in handy. See you around. The old man nods and goes back to what he was doing. Yeah, wearing new workers' clothing. Hello again. Thanks for everything. Alright, so, yeah. A silver butane lighter in good condition. Don't I have other lighters? No, someone else does. Good to see you again. Tom's been a bigger help around here. Thanks again for sorting all that out. Now what can I do for you? The Abbey, friend. Out of curiosity. I am liked in the Abbey. So in order to do some of these, I have to go to Gecko and to Norino. And I forget where we get the stuff for the water pump. Maybe he'll refresh my memory. That's New Reno again, or Vault City? I think it's Vault City, actually. Oh, right. I wanted to see if these... Yeah, that goes out. Out. They all go out. That's interesting. Oh, right. They wanted me to... I have something else to ask this guy? I don't remember. I hear they meant to talk to you about caravans. I might know a thing or two. Would you like to know? How often do you get resupplied? I get a new shipment of supplies twice a month. Frankly, I wish they'd come more often. But we're only on a minor trade route, so I guess this is the best we've got. Are the caravans hiring? I'm not quite sure. Usually the ones that stop by here are pretty well equipped and not really interested in hanging around very long. But if you're looking to hook up with one of them, I'd head over to Reading or even down to NCR. They've got pretty active caravans and good help is always wanted. Alright. Where's the car area? Have I looked in here? No, I haven't. Nothing. Okay. Old city, I guess, to get that part. Yeah, it's not far. Pretty sure it's Vault City. Over here. Dave sent me. We're trying to fix a broken water pump, and he said you'd have a replacement motor. Working with Dave, eh? Yeah, I know the fella. I see he's still got a knack for getting others to do his legwork. Lazy bastard. Anyway, I think I got what you're looking for, but let me just go back and check. Harry goes into his back room where you hear boxes being shuffled and moved around. He returns a minute later. Yep, got it right here. $500 and she's all yours. Now I could make more money out of this. $500? Hey, maybe you could give me some kind of discount. I mean, you and Dave are friends, right? Tell you the truth, I never really cared for the fella. $500 for the motor. Take it or leave it. Fine, here's the money. Thanks for the business. Take care. Love the song. See if he's got anything else. And probably not. Oh, here's the part. So yes, I have those things already, but I'll hold on to them. Much. Make back our money and then some. Alright, luckily it wasn't too far, especially using our automobile. Back to the Abbey. I feel nauseous. I was afraid we got over being an addict, but nope. Let's take a look at this part. A 40 HP electric motor, 14 pounds. It's a stubborn son bitch. Yo. Yep, got the part right here. Excellent. Want me to install the damn thing, or do you want the pleasure? Huh. Think I can handle it. Step aside. Why not? I failed to repair the pump. One more try, but I'm breaking it. Alright. I've done nothing this job. Go ahead and install it yourself. Alright, fine. Hand it over. Here you go. What a piece of shit this is. The water pump has been repaired. 150 experience. You should notify the head monk that the water pump is now fixed. Hey, thanks for fixing the water pump. I'm causing trouble now, I hear. The water pump is working fine now. The head monk? Is that the abbot? Well, we said he would have said abbot, wouldn't he? Who's the head monk? I can tell this guy we've solved the problem without him. Maybe it's him? Doubt it. Brother John, maybe? Maybe it is the abbot, I don't know. It is, okay. Why did they call him the head monk and not the abbot? I fixed your broken water pump. That is great news indeed. That water pump has been acting up for quite some time. Those merchants said they could take care of it, but they didn't seem to be making much progress. It's a good thing you came along. Thank you again. Okay. I get the distinct feeling that if I ask him for money, he's not going to be happy. Besides, the guy already gave me some money. Only $100, but eh. Get the experience, 5 karma. I see a shadow. Don't do that. You don't do that. Where is it? Okay. We've done a bunch of crap. before I do anything about formatting crap, I do want to collect information about botany from somewhere. I think maybe from the abandoned shack. But that we died there, so we need to level up first. So I need to head back to New Reno to tell Father Tully about Brother Samuel here. And I need to escort Brother Jason to Gecko. So that stuff will be next episode. At least one of them, anyway. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.